What's going on, guys? Wingspan here, and welcome back to another tutorial. And today, guys, I'm going to show you how to make this really cool and simple password lock door. And if you guys are excited for that, definitely leave a like down below and subscribe if you're new. We're on the road to 1000, so that would definitely help a lot. And without further ado, let's get straight into the tutorial. Alright, guys, first of all, I'm going to show you how this works. As you can see, some of the blocks are marked in white to just give you guys a little bit better idea of what's going on. This iron block represents where we need to throw our little keycard or the password, and this can be any block that you want. In this case, it's just a piece of paper that's renamed, and you can use any block that you want. So just go ahead and throw your keycard right on top of that, and as you can see, the door is going to open. You can go inside your base, do whatever you want, and when you want to exit and close the door, you're going to come to these blocks over here. Now obviously you would head at this quartz or whatever block that you're using, pretty much going in some kind of the decoration. So these blocks are actually stairs, and as you can see, we have a normal stair over here and another that's curved, which pretty much makes this little block with the chunk missing, and this chunk is pretty much transparent, which means you can click right through it. So we have the button right behind that, and if you have some of the other quartz blocks over here or any block that has a stair variant, you can pretty much make a little design and no one would be able to notice this. So just go ahead and click the corner of that chunk over there, and as you can see, through the ground, our little password is going to come right back, and the door is going to close. Of course, this can be any door that you want. I just went for a simple 3x3 door, but you can go as big or as small as you want for this. And the great part of this is that this is actually incredibly simple. Now, this may look complicated, but the heart of the little machine is right here in the nice little 3x3 area. And all there is a simple item sorter over here. As you can see, you would probably use this kind of stuff in the sorting systems for the chests and stuff. So you can see that in this hopper right here, we have set up a nice little password reading area. You can see that we have some block of iron, but you can use any block that you want. Just rename it and just type some of the random letters and stuff, so no one would be able to guess it. And in the first slot, you pretty much have to put 18 of the items of your choice. Again, in this case, it was paper. So any more item that you put in over here, it's going to go right past this, and it's going to end up in this dropper over here. As you can see, when the item is inside the dropper, we are not going to have a signal over here, which means the door is going to open. But as soon as we take the item out of there, the redstone is going to get back on, which means the door is going to get closed. Then we have a really simple little dropper operator, which pretty much activates by this button over here. Once the or little item or the password is in this dropper, the door is going to open, and the only way to get the password back in to the surface is by pressing this button over here. As you can see, just a really simple staircase going down, and excuse me, slime, you're gonna have to move a little bit. But pretty much the redstone is going down, and the first thing that's gonna get activated is this block right underneath this dropper over here, which means that this dropper is going to shoot the item in this one over here. Then this torch is going to get deactivated, which is going to activate this torch over here, and it's going to create a nice little sequence, which is pretty much going to send our little password all the way up to the surface and on the floor over here. So that's really simple, and the main thing about this is that you have this torch over here. Otherwise, if we didn't have this torch, as you can see, this redstone would always be activated, and it would kind of lock this hopper, and it wouldn't allow this dropper over here to pretty much shoot the item right there. So we need to make sure that we actually deactivate this in the normal state. So we just needed a little redstone pointing into the block underneath the torch over there, and that was just deactivated. So over here you can see that we have a nice little 3x3 door. Again, you can go as big or as small as you want, but the main thing is that this is the redstone line that we are using, and we're going to explain this a little bit better when we start the tutorial. But from this redstone line you can go anywhere that you want and you can build pretty much anything. So that's pretty much all there is for redstone, and I'm going to show you how to build it right now. So guys, we're going to do this step by step, and we're pretty much going to make a little heart of the machine, the sorting system. So just go ahead, grab yourself a couple of the hoppers and have one leading into it like that, and another one on top leading in this hopper over here. Then we're going to need another one that's pointing in that direction, which is going to lead into the dropper, and just put it like that. Then we need to lock this hopper over here, so just go ahead and mine the block underneath, and put the redstone torch on the side of that block right there, and that's going to lock the hopper. Then just go ahead and put the comparator leading from this hopper over here outwards like this, and have it pointing in to the block. And then just go ahead, put the redstone dust over here and another one going into this box. So that way, once we put the right keycard in, it's going to deactivate this redstone torch, and it's going to allow one item to pretty much go inside of this dropper over here. Then the next thing we need to do is grab the signal from this dropper once the item reaches there. So we need to go ahead and put the comparator going out of this dropper over here, with the redstone dust over here leading into the block, with the redstone torch on the other side. Then go ahead and put the block on top of that torch over here, and another block right down there, and two more blocks leading upwards like that. And go ahead, put your repeater right there. And as you can see, in the normal state, without of the item over here, the redstone torch over here is going to get the power to this block, which we're going to transfer using the repeater into this block right here. And this is where all of the magic happens. You can pretty much lead this redstone anywhere. Just go ahead and pretty much build it and lead it anywhere that you want. We are going to go in this direction, so we can just go ahead and do it like that, and pretty much lead it anywhere that you want. Then we're going to set up a little dropper elevator, just three droppers going upwards like that. And that's going to shoot the item on top of the ground. Of course, the ground level would be one block above of the redstone. So just go ahead and make yourself a little platform. Or if you're doing this in survival, just go ahead and have this kind of dug out. And make sure that you prepared a nice little hole. So once we pretty much make this little platform going down over here, we can pretty much set up all of the rest of the redstone. So just go ahead and locate your dropper over here, and the way we can pretty much drop the item on the floor and it's going to get down there is of course using the minecart with the hopper. So go ahead, grab yourself a piece of the rail, hold sneak and put it on top of that little hopper right there. Go ahead, put your minecart with the hopper, and of course put the block on top of that. Pretty much covering it right there, or I'm just going to do that with the iron block to kind of make it a little bit easier for you guys to see what's going on again. So as you can see, the minecart with the hopper is underneath this block, and pretty much anything that we throw on top of it is going to get sucked down. Then we pretty much need to go ahead and build a nice little wall over here. So just go ahead, grab your block of the choice, and of course have it on top of the redstone like that, and just have it leading out over here. You can make this as tall as you want, but I'm just going to go for 3 blocks high over here. So just go ahead and do something like that. Then you can like punch out these 2 blocks, and that's when we can set up a nice little button over here. So just go ahead, put the stair normal way just like that, and put another one curved like that, and we're going to have a block that's kind of have a little chunk missing. Then just go ahead and have one block out over here, and have the button right across that, so make sure that there is one block gap in between them. So just go ahead and put your button right there. Then we can pretty much go ahead and lead the redstone down. So just go ahead and do it like that, and lead it all the way to the ground over here. Then we are going to need to set up that little sequence, which is going to shoot the item all the way up. So pretty much all we need to do is have the redstone right near this dropper over here at the side. dig a little hole over here and place the redstone torch right there. Have the block on top of it, and as you can see, this is going to get activated. Then just go ahead, put the block on top of that and the redstone on the blocks like so. And as you can see, that's going to get activated. Then we are going to need to dig a nice little hole over here. So just go ahead and do like a 3x3 area over here. Just like that, and we can pretty much lead the redstone down from the button. So just go ahead and place the redstone going all the way down through the stairs, and of course have the block right there. So again, the first thing that we need to power is this dropper over here. So dig a block underneath the start of the drop elevator and pretty much have the redstone leading right there into the block that's directly underneath the dropper over here. Then we need to have our redstone torch right on this side and have the redstone going like that. Dig this block over here and place the repeater set to 2 tick delay, so just click it once like that. So that we're going to make sure that this is the line that's going to get activated first, and then the drop elevator is going to shoot upwards. So that just adds a little bit delay and make the whole thing smoother. Then another thing that you need to do is pretty much have this dropper over here at the block of the floor pretty much surrounded from all of the sides, so put the block right there. If you didn't have this block over here, the password or any item could just shoot at this side, so we need to make sure that all of the sides are covered. So just go ahead and put the block right there, and that way the item is going to travel all the way up. Then of course we need to go ahead and grab ourselves a little bit of the anvil and pretty much rename some of the items. Then once you get all of that done, pretty much insert them into this hopper over here. Of course you can use any block that you want and just put some of the random stuff and pretty much have them go into these 4 slots. So no one would be able to guess it. And of course go ahead, grab yourself a piece of the paper or anything that you want, and pretty much rename it in whatever password you wanted to have, and make sure that you have 18 pieces of it and put it inside of the hopper. That way they are not going to flow out, and of course if you have another one, it's just going to flow straight through this dropper over here. So that's pretty much all there is for that. Now you can pretty much go from this signal and create any kind of the redstone door that you want. So once you install your door, you can pretty much make sure that everything is working fine. Just go ahead, chuck your item in, and as you can see, the door is going to open. Then again, when you want to close it, just pretty much click the button right there, and it's going to pop right through the floor. And of course, to show you that this is absolutely 100% cheat proof, you can't just throw any old item because it wouldn't work. As you can see, I can like throw the sticky piston in and nothing is going to happen. I can pretty much just go ahead and chuck some of the random stuff and nothing is going to happen. Of course, unless we put the correct password in which case the door is going to open, as you can see. And again, just go ahead, click the button and you're going to get it right back. Alright guys, that's pretty much all there is for this video. If you guys enjoyed it, make sure to leave a like down below and subscribe if you're new. We are on the road to 1000, so that would definitely help a lot. And really quick before we end the episode, guys, do me a favor and go check out my handcraft series. I know most of my views come from the tutorials like this one, so if you are into survival, check out my handcraft series. It's amazing multiplayer survival server. And we do a lot of the nice things over there, so definitely if you're into survival, give it a chance and see if you like it. And if you don't like it, just move on. But yeah, that's pretty much all there is. I really hope you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching and peace out.